Now you'll hear it from your neighbour, and you'll wear it down the pub, and you'll cop it from your own best mate as he belts it in your lug. Now I have had just about enough, so it's come to this, you see, and I'm tired of all this bull and scaly tales you're telling me. Now I know it don't seem right to you that I should feel like this, 'cause you're not an Aussie through and through if you don't drink fighting fish. And you question what else there's to do, time away to pass, without drinking, skiting, bluing and fighting for no fish in a wet outfit. Then you come in my house annoying me, gabbing who caught this and that, and I'm about as interested in fishing, mate, as I am in the neighbour's cat. So take your flaming hat, your faithful rod and your stinking prawns, and remove that leaking boat of yours off my flaming lawn. 'Cause I don't care if the fish weren't biting and you should have stayed in bed, and while dragging for bait, your wife got bogged and a croc ate your dog instead. And I couldn't give the horse's rear if your 9.9 caught fire, 'cause the only time a fisherman tells the truth is when he calls another a liar. Now take that old faithful trusty rod, the one you've had for years. I'd like to borrow it for a tick and wrap it around your ears. Then just to show my interest in your interest, I suppose, I'd like to shove your bait box, mud and all, right up your nose. Now don't get me wrong, though I don't fish, I'll nudge a can or two, but there's more for me in life, you see, than a romp in the ocean blue. And we're still mates, that's Ridgey Ditch, but there's times I feel I oughta tie your bottom lip to the prop and start the flaming motor. Yeah, I've tried to make you understand and hoped you'd stay away, but I'll be gaffed if you're not back to spruiking again next day. So it's come to this, old mate, old friend, from the bottom of my heart. Take your boat and oars, your photo of Jaws, your rod and hers and your secret lures, your live bait box and your old crab pot, your stinking hooks and your fishing books, your Dundee knife and your ugly wife. Take your favourite rum and your favourite flask, and do the obvious is all I ask. 'Cause I don't care if the fish weren't biting and you should have stayed in bed, while dragging for bait, your wife got bogged and a croc ate your dog instead. And I couldn't give the horse's rear if your 9.9 caught fire, 'cause the only time a fisherman tells the truth is when he calls another a liar. No, I don't care if the fish weren't biting and you should have stayed in bed, while dragging for bait, your wife got bogged and a croc ate your dog instead. And I couldn't give the horse's rear if your 9.9 caught fire, 'cause the only time a fisherman tells the truth is when he calls another a liar. But the skeeters are little buggers gone hiding. They don't want to get caught. It's too nice a day to be dangling on the end of a line. That a bad day's fishing beats a good day's work every time. Little old worm around a big old hook, he don't mind the water in this Babylon brook, just swimming around and having a flaming good time. He knows a bad day's fishing beats a good day's work every time. Well, a bad day's fishing ain't a bad day at all, just as long as you're a-wetting the line. For when the man up above is a-tallying up, he's gonna look down on you and he'll smile. You'll say,
a day spent fishing is good for your soul, so I just add it to the end of your life.
And a bad day's fishing beats a good day's work every time.